Hello, good morning. Last time we discussed about the phase diagrams of the copper alloy and lead tin phase diagram. Today we discuss about the iron carbon phase diagram. This is the iron carbon phase diagram. Generally this is called the iron carbon diagram. Here it is. In this diagram we take the on x axis the composition of the carbons and on the y axis temperature in terms of the degree centigrade, and here it is, the composition will be on 1, 2, 3, and these are up to the 6.70 carbon weight percentage, and this region is called the steel alloy region, and this called is the cast iron region. Here it is, the temperature is vary from 400 to 600 degree centigrade. Here it is, the firstly this is the melting point of the iron, 1538 degree centigrade. On this temperature, this is in the liquid form. This is the region of the liquid region of the iron composition, and when we cool it up to the 1493 degree centigrade, then this reaction is called the pre-eutectic reaction. So this reaction is the pre-eutectic reaction. This is occur at the 493 degree centigrade, and when it is the composition is here, the beta BCC is occur. Del BCC is occur, that is called the del ferrite. And here it is, when it is cooled up to the 1400 degree centigrade, then it is, this is the line of liquidus line, and this is the line of the solidus line, and this is the maximum solubility of the carbon, and here it is the combination of the gamma plus L. Gamma is the austenite and the L is in liquid. This region is the austenite and its structure is FCC, and this is the eutectic reaction line, and here it is, the composition of the carbon is 2.14, and at this point the carbon composition is 4.13 at the temperature of 1143 degree centigrade. So this reaction is occur on the 1140 degree centigrade. So this reaction is called the eutectic reaction. Here it is, after some cooling, after the austenite, here it is the combination of the gamma plus alpha. Here it is the gamma plus alpha means austenite plus alpha ferronite. Here it is again the maximum solubility of the carbon, and this composition is at on the 0.022 weight percentage of the carbon. And here this reaction is called the eutectoid reaction. In this reaction, the combination of the alpha and gamma and alpha is converted into the alpha ferrite, and this structure is BCC structure. And this reaction is occur at on 727 degree centigrade. So here it is, when the composition is increased, this region is called the austenite plus the cementite, and this region is the ferrite plus the perlite. And after the combination of the carbon after 6.70 degree centigrade, then the pure graphite is obtained, and this is the iron carbon diagram. And here it is, the dotted line shows this point is the eutectic point, and here it is this region from here to here, this is the hypoeutectoid. This is the hypoeutectoid region and this is the hypereutectoid region. Similarly, this region from here to here, this region is hypereutectic region and this is hypoeutectic region. So here it is, the combination of the austenite and the austenite and the cementite combination is obtained, and here it is the perlite and the ferrite combination is obtained. So this is the iron carbon diagram, and the different reactions is formed then. So these are the invariant reaction in the iron carbon diagram. The first pericactic reactions, as we see the first reaction, then the composition of the carbon is 0.08%, and its structure is ferrite BCC structure and plus liquid 0.55 weight percentage of carbon, and it's converted to gamma, that is austenite, and BCC structure where the carbon composition is 0.18 weight percentage, and it is occur on 1493 as we see in the iron carbon diagram. Eutectic reaction, this is the combination of L 4.3 weight percentage of carbon, and this convert into the after the temperature is cooling from 493 to 1147 degree centigrade, then it is gamma plus cementite combination, and the carbon composition is 2.06 weight percentage of carbon, and here it is the 6.67 weight percentage of carbon. It is nearly about the 6.70 weight percentage of the carbon. So here it is the cementite, and here it is the austenite. Now the next reaction is eutectoid reaction. In this reaction, the austenite which contain the 0.76 weight percentage of carbon, and it's converted into the alpha plus perlite, and this is the combination composition of the carbon 0.025 weight percentage of carbon, and its structure is BCC ferrite structure, and this is the perlite, and it is also 6.67 weight percentage of carbon, and it is occur at the 727 degree centigrade. So this is when the temperature is 1147 degree centigrade, then this combination is called cementite, and when the temperature is go down up to the 727 degree centigrade, then this is the perlite. So this is the different reactions in the iron carbon diagram occurs. This is the structure of the alpha ferrite and the austenite. So this is the photomicrographic structure of the alpha ferrite, which is zoomed at the 19 pixels, and this is the austenite structure of the 325 pixel. So these are the structures of the ferrite and the austenite. This is the microstructures of when the eutectoid composition and hypoeutectoid and hyper-eutectoid composition is occur. So here it is at the temperature of 727 degree centigrade. So this is the again this is alpha ferrite, and this is the eutectoid reactions, and here it is on the eutectoid the reaction point. So this is the line, and this is the first composition we take. This is around 0.76 degree, sorry 0.76 weight percentage of the carbon, and at the this region, this is the austenite region, and here we obtain the pure form of the austenite at the temperature of 800 degree centigrade, and after the eutectoid temperature, here it is we obtain the perlite and the ferrite combination we obtain. So this is the perlite and the pro-eutectoid ferrite combination. So this is the microstructure of the perlite and the ferrite. After the composition is changed, means after the before the eutectoid point and this line, and here it is the composition is around 0.25 degree centigrade. Here it is the composition is 0.76 weight percentage, and so here it is, this is called the hypoeutectoid composition, and this is denote as the C1 point, and here it is this point we obtain the pure austenite and after the cooling the temperature, this is on at the temperature of 775 degree centigrade, and here it is at a D point, this is at the 850 degree centigrade and this is at the 775 degree centigrade at the D point. We obtained the austenite and the some composition of gamma. And here it is at the point of nearly about the eutectoid temperature. Here we obtained the 50% austenite and 50% cementite we obtained because it is above the eutectoid temperature. And here below the eutectoid temperature, just below the eutectoid temperature, here it is this is the combination of perlite and the ferrite, and this is the microstructures of when the hypoeutectoid composition, and next is the hyper-eutectoid composition, and when the composition is just after the eutectoid point, and it is up to the 1.14 weight percentage of carbon, means it is between the 0.76 to 2.14 weight percentage of carbon. We take this combination, and at the D point, and it is the at the D point, the austenite is completely austenite is formed, and this structure is completely austenite, and here it is the austenite plus cementite is obtained on this point, just above the eutectoid point, and just below the eutectoid point we obtain the perlite and the austenite, and these are the different microstructures of the when the eutectoids and the hypoeutectoid and hyper-eutectoid reactions occur. A portion of the iron carbon phase diagram using the composition for the relative amount for the pro-eutectoid and the perlite microconstitute for the hypoeutectoid, which is denoted by C0-, and the hyper-eutectoid, which is denoted by the C1 composition. So here it is, this is the composition C0-, and this is the C1 composition, and this is the eutectoid point at the 0.75 weight percentage of the carbon. So here it is, this is the 0.022. So here it is denoted by the T, and it is denoted by U, and this is denoted by V, and here to here this is denoted by X, and this is the region of the perlite and the ferrite, and this is the Leavitt's rule formula, and in this formula we have T upon T plus U, and these composition is put up in this formula and calculate the mass fraction of the perlite and the mass fraction of the ferrite, and the again the mass fraction of the perlite in terms of the X and V. This is the deeper rule formula for the iron carbon phase diagram. Phase transformation, this is the new topic, and what is the phase transformation? The phase transformation means change the number of phases when the heat treatment processes occurs, and the characteristics of the phases will take place. And here it is the three types of the diffusion dependence. The first one is the simple diffusion dependence, second is more complicated diffusion dependent, and the third is the diffusion less. In the simple diffusion dependence, no change in the number of the phases, means the we use the single type of metal or the pure metal. So here it is the no change in the number of phases and no change in the composition. We take the single component, that's why the single composition is here. For example, the solidification of the pure metal, allostropic transformation, recrystallization and growth grain, these are the simple diffusion is occur in this part. The more complicated diffusion depends the change in number of phases means number of phases are the obtains like the solid, liquid and the semi-solid solid solutions, and the change in composition as we will see in the electrolyte reactions. Diffusion less, example better stable, better stable phase, for example the martensite, so these are the phase transformation. Again the phase transformation is, most phase transformation begin with the formation of the numerous small particles of the new phase that increase in the size until the transformation is complete. The progress of a phase transformation may be broken down into the two distinct stage, that is the nucleation and second one is the growth stage. In the nucleation is the process whereby the nuclei act as the template for the crystal growth, and during the growth stage these nuclei increase in size which result in the disappearance of the sum or all the parent phases. And this nucleation is divided into two, that is the homogeneous nucleation and the heterogeneous nucleation. The homogeneous nucleation, nuclei form uniformly throughout the parent phase, required considerable supercooling. It is and occur at the 300 degree centigrade, sorry 80 to 300 degree centigrade. And second is the heterogeneous nucleation, form at the structural inhomogeneous peak, and it contain and is obtained the container surface, impurities, grain boundaries, dislocation in the liquid phase much easier, and the since stable nucleating surface is already present and required a slightly cool from 0.1 to 10 degree centigrade. So this is the heterogeneous nucleation. Now what is it is what is the term supercooling? During the cooling of the liquid, solidification means the nucleation will begin only after the temperature has been lowered below the equilibrium solidification, that is the melting temperature. These phenomena is called the supercooling or undercooling. The driving force to the nucleate increase at the del T increase. Del T means the change in temperature. All some small supercooling is slow nucleation rate, means the generation of the nucleus is very slow and the few nucleus are generated and the crystal size will be large. The large supercooling, the rapid nucleation rate, means the nucleation rate is high and many nucleations are the developed and the crystal size is small. This is the table of degree of the supercooling, del T, the values of the homogeneous nucleation for the several metals. Here it is the sum, antimony, germany, silver, gold, copper, iron, nickel, cobalt, and these are the del T temperatures of these which is used in the numerical. And now the nucleation and the growth term, the rate is the result of the nucleation and the growth crystal. So here we take a graph, on y axis we take the percentage of the perlite and on the x axis we take the time, and here it is the nucleation rhythm and this is the growth rhythm. So this is the beginning of the growth region and this is the end of the growth region. The nucleation rate is increased by the W upon del T and the growth rate increased W by T. So here it is the nucleation and here it is at the 50% perlite is composition of 50% perlite and the time will be the 0.50, and here it is some example, the T is just below the electrolyte temperature and the nucleation rate is low and the growth rate is high, and here it is we see the perlite colony is very less and the austenite is more. So So here it is the perlite colony layer, because the T is just below the eutectoid temperature. Here it is the T is the moderate below the eutectoid temperature. The nucleation rate is medium and the growth rate is medium. So here it is the some more the perlite colony developed in this region where the moderate temperature is occur, and this, these are the again the perlite colony, and in the violet color this is the austenite, and in the third diagram the T is always below the TE, means the eutectoid temperature, it is T is always away from the eutectoid temperature, and nucleation in this condition the nucleation rate is high and the growth rate is low. And here it is the perlite colony is in small in size. So here it is the, but the spread up in the full way. So this is the nucleation and the growth term. Now the nucleation of the spherical solid particle in a liquid. So here it is the solid particle and this is the liquid particle, and this is the liquid region and this is the solid, and it is spherical in shape. That's why the volume, we take the 4 by 3 pi r cube and its area is 4 pi r square, and this is the solid liquid interface, means the surface of the solid and liquid. The change in the free energy, which is denoted by the del g, it is the function of the internal energy as the enthalpy used in thermodynamic system, must be negative for the transformation to occur. Assume that the nuclei of the solid phase form in the entire of the liquid as an atom cluster together, similar to the packing in the solid phase. Also, each nucleus in the spherical and has the radius is r. The free energy change as the result of transformation. First, the difference between the solid and the liquid, which is denoted by the volume free and del g v, and the solid liquid phase boundary, the surface free energy, and which is denoted by del g s, and this is the total free energy del g, and it is the summation of surface free energy and the volume free energy, and this is the formula we use. Here it is the transforming one phase into the another takes some time. So here it is the carbon composition with the austenite, and its structure is FCC, and iron and carbon composition in black in color, and after the eutectoid transformation, the here it is the composition of the cementite and the ferrite. So this is the structure is BCC. The initially the structure is FCC, after the transformation its structure is BCC. Now homogeneous nucleation and the energy effect, it is shown by the curve. Here on the y-axis we take the free energy change, which is denoted by del g. On the x-axis the growth in radius of the nucleus. So here it is the curve of the surface energy, and here it is the curve of the volume energy, and this is the critical free energy change curve, which is denoted the total free energy, and which is denoted by the del gs plus del gv. So here it is, from here to here this is the critical nucleus, this is the critical nucleus. So when the nucleus is shrink, then the radius will be shrink, and this value is less than the value of critical radius, and when the nucleus growth is increased, then the value of critical radius is less than the growth value of the radius. And here it is the formula of this del s by the 4 pi r square gamma, and gamma is here the surface tension value, and del v value is 4 by 3 pi r cube, del v and del V value is volume free energy and unit volume. So this is the curve of the homogeneous nucleation and energy effects. Now the solidification. So here in the previous slide we see the critical radius value, and the critical radius value is calculated by this formula. Here it is the Tm is the melting temperature, and here it is the change in temperature which is denoted by del T, and here it is the latent heat of the solidification, del Hf is latent heat of solidification, and gamma is the surface free energy, and this is the difference which is called the supercooling, and here it is, this is the total free energy, and by this formula we calculate the total free energy, and the term will be same, and R is the critical radius value, and it is nearly about the 10 nanometer. Now heterogeneous nucleation. The activation energy means the energy barrier for the nucleation. It is lowered when the nucleation form on the pre-existing surface on the inner face. The surface free energy gamma is reduced. So here it is the liquid surface, and here it is the these two are the solid inner face, and this is the liquid inner face, and here it is the solid liquid the surface tension value, surface free energy value. So this is the surface free energy value, and this is the inner face value, and these are the this is the solid curve, and this is the liquid region, and the angle between these two is denoted by the theta, and by this formula we calculate the inner surface of the liquid. Now the another curve is the combination of the homogeneous and heterogeneous nucleation, the critical free energy and the critical radius in terms of here it is in red in color, this is the homogeneous nucleation curve, and in blue in color this is the heterogeneous nucleation curve, and this is the critical radius value, and this is the value from here to here, this is the free energy of the homogeneous, and this is the free energy of heterogeneous, means total free energy of heterogeneous and total free energy of homogeneous, and again this is the critical radius value by this calculated by this formula, and the heterogeneous free energy is calculated by this formula, and homogeneous value calculated by this formula, and theta is again we see in the previous slide, the angle between this is the theta value, okay, and this is the angle between the intersurface of the solid and the solid liquid surface line. Now the transformation and undercooling. The eutectoid transformation for the iron carbon system, here again the austenite is the composition after the cooling is ferrite plus cementite, and the gamma is 0.76 weight percentage of the carbon, and ferrite is 0.022 weight percentage of carbon, and the cementite 6.7 weight percentage of carbon. The eutectoid transformation, for the transformation to occur, must cool to below the 727 degree centigrade. This is the eutectoid temperature, and it is cooled to the from this temperature 727 degree centigrade, so under cool by the this transformation, and then we occur the ferrite plus the perlite. So this is the equilibrium cooling transformation below the 727 degree centigrade. Now the rate phase transformation, here it is the curve of the fraction transferred transform, which is denoted by y, and again this is the time, and this is the nucleation part, and this is the growth part, and this is the beginning. This point is the rate increase as the surface area increase and the nucleus growth, and this is the beginning point, and this is the maximum rate reached. Now the amount unconverted decrease to the rate slows, and this is the transform is completed, means the end of the transformation, and this is the equation by which we calculate the value of fraction transform, Abrahamian equation, and 1 minus exponential of the minus kt to the power n, and fraction transformation is depends on the time, that's why we take the here the time, and the rate of convection is calculated by 1 upon t 0.5, and t 0.5 is just we take the time from here, and this is the composition of the fraction transform. The Abrahamian relation, the rate is defined as the inverse of the time to complete the half of the transformation, that describe most solid state transformation that involve diffusion. Temperature depends of transformation rate. So here in this curve, this is the percentage of recrystalline, and this is the time, and here it is the when the time increase, the cooling is go down, and this is the temperature is reduced 135, 190 degree centigrade, 130 degree centigrade, 100 degree centigrade, 88 degree centigrade, and 43 degree centigrade. So when the time is decreased, then the cooling is occur. The temperature will have a profound influence on the kinetic and thus on the rate of the transformation. The percent crystallization as a function of the time at the constant temperature for the pure copper, and in the general rate increase as T, the temperature is increased, and this is the again the R is equal to the rate, and you see in the previous slide, and this is the rate we calculate by this formula 1 upon T 0.5. So if we use this equation is here, and this is the Abrahamian expression, and R is the gas constant, T is the temperature, A is the pre-exponential rate factor, and Q is the activation energy, and R is often small, so equilibrium is not possible. Okay, so this is the temperature depends on the transformation rate. Eutectoid transformation rate, that is denoted by del T, the transformation of the austenite to the perlite. Here it is in first diagram, the austenite grain boundary. This is the austenite grain boundary, and this is the combination of the cementite and the ferrite. The cementite is in red in color, and the ferrite is in green in color. So here it is the boundary of austenite, and it is go through the perlite growth. This is the direction of the perlite growth direction. And in second diagram, the diffusion of the carbon during the transformation. This diagram is shows the diffusion of the carbon in this diagram. And composition will be same, the cementite and the ferrite. For this transformation, increase the value of del T, and which is calculated by the eutectoid temperature and the melting temperature. And again we see the percentage of the ferrite on y-axis at the time, and it is cooling, and now this time when the temperature is increased, then it is further temperature is increased, the time is increased, then the temperature is increased, and this is here we take the percentage of the austenite, because here it is the combination of the cementite perlite and the cementite on when the del t is larger than the, this curve is straighter in form, and here it is the when the temperature is increased, then the curve will be slightly slope. The cores for light formed as a higher temperature relatively soft, and the fine perlite formed at the at lower temperature relatively hard. This is isothermal transformation diagram. This is also called time temperature transformation, and in short we write TTT curve. So here it is the two curve, and the first represent the time required to each temperature for the start of the transformation, and the other is for the transformation is complete. The dash curve is correspond, sorry, the dash curve is correspond to the 50% completion, the austenite to the perlite. The transformation will occur only if the alloy is supercooled to below the heated point temperature 727 degree centigrade, and time for the process to complete depend on the temperature. Here we see this is the curve, and this is the percentage of the austenite and transformed to the perlite, and this is the time on x-axis, and this is the TTT curve, and this is the temperature, and this is the time. So here it is, this is the heated point temperature, and this is the austenite phase which is stable, and below the heated point temperature the austenite is unstable. At the beginning of the transformation, here it is, we see this is the beginning of the transformation. At this time the 0% of the perlite form, and at the 50% of the transformation is complete at the temperature of 675 degree centigrade, and this is denoted by the blue dashed line, and at this time the 50% completion curve of the transformation, and this is the green line which shows the completion curve, means the 100% perlite is obtained from this curve. Here it is, this is the transformation is complete, and here it is, this shows the completion and 100% perlite is obtained. This is the isothermal transformation diagram, and this is the microstructures of at this time, and eutectoid iron carbon alloy and composition we take again 0.76 weight percentage of carbon, and the beginning is at the melting temperature, and it is always greater than the 727 degree centigrade. Rapid cool to the 626 degree centigrade and hold isothermally. This is hold isothermally. So here the graph is again between the temperature and the time, and these are the same curve as we see in the previous slide, means is convert the austenite to the perlite. Here this is the convert into the austenite to the perlite. So this region is completely austenite when it is stable, and this is the when it is shown by this line, this is the austenite, and this is at the midpoint, this is the 50% perlite, 50% austenite, and at the end, at the D point, the it is the combination of the ferrite and the perlite, and this line shows the that the transformation is occurring. This line shows transformation is occurring. Transformation involves non-eutectoid composition, that is the composition is 1.13 weight percentage of the carbon, and here it is again the, this is the temperature and this is the time, and this is the phase diagram of the iron carbon, and here it is at this time the curve will be like that, and this is the austenite region, this is stable and this is unstable region, this is the cementite region, and this is the austenite and perlite, and here it is the perlite region. It is just below the eutectoid temperature, and it is combination is this is just above the eutectoid temperature, and this is the just below the eutectoid temperature. And again here the composition is 1.13 composition, and this is hyper eutectoid composition, and it is called pro-eutectoid cementite. Now the possible transformation, austenite when it is slow cooling occur, then the perlite plus a pro-eutectoid phase is obtained, and when the moderate cooling is occur, then bainite is occur, and the rapid quench is in process, then the martensite, and it is reheated, then the tempered martensite is obtained. It means when these are the different composition after the cooling of the austenite, the martensite, tempered martensite, bainite, fine perlite, coarse perlite, spherulite, and these are the general trends. So here it is, the strength is increased and here the ductility is decreased. So here it is the structure of the bainite when it is non-equilibrium transformation product. The elongate the FeC3 particle in the alpha ferrite matrix or diffusion controls, and alpha lays strip with the long rods in the FeC3. So this is FeC3 is the cementite, and this is the ferrite region. Here it is, this is the ferrite region, and the dark line of black in color is cementite, and this is the bainite, and this is the TTT curve of these three austenite, and we obtain from the 0% of bainite and 50% of bainite and 100% of bainite or cementite. And this is 100% perlite. So this is the cooled curve, and this shows the 100% perlite, and this shows the 100% bainite. This is the microstructure of the bainite. The bainite consists of the acetabular, which is the needle-like structure, ferrite with very small cementite particle dispersed throughout. The carbon content is typically greater than 0.1%. Bainite transformed to the iron and cementite with the sufficient time and temperature consists the semi-stable below the 150 degree centigrade. This is the bainite microstructure, and these are the needle-like structure which is black in color. Spherulite, FeC3 particle within the alpha matrix, and this is the again the TTT diagram for this, and spherulite is obtained when the these are the cooling. So this is the rapid cooling, and it is stable up to the 10^4 seconds, and when it is and obtain the 100 spherulite, and when it is the rapid cooling and it is stable for the 10^4 or 5, then the 100% spherulite is formed. So this is the martensite formation. The isothermal diagram. In this diagram, we see this is the rapid cooling, and the single phase diagram, the body centered tetrahydrogonal, which is called the BCT crystal structure, BTC, and the combination of the carbon weight percentage is 0.15, and the diffusion less transformation, and BTC is the few slip planes, and it is hard and brittle in nature. The percentage transformation depend only the T of the rapid cooling. So here it is the diagram, we see the temperature variations, and we obtain the 0%, 50%, 100%, and the martensite is obtained at the 0% at the just above the 200 degree centigrade, and just below the 200 degree centigrade we obtain the 50% of martensite, and at the night and At the 150 degree centigrade, we obtain the mattersite and austenite, and then it is cooling, rapid cooling. So in this diagram, the black color shows the mattersite needles and the austenite is white in color. So here it is the combination of 50-50% of austenite and 50% of mattersite, and here it is the 80% of mattersite, 90% of mattersite and 10% of austenite. And this is the micrography of the austenite that was the polished flat and then allowed to transform into the mattersite. The different colors indicate the displacement caused when the mattersite formed. So we take the first example, iron carbon alloy with the eutectoid composition. The specific the nature of the final microstructure, the percentage of the barite, martensite, perlite, etc. for the alloy that is the subjected to the following time temperature treatment. The alloy begin at the 760 degree centigrade and has been held long enough to achieve a complete and the homogeneous austenite structure. The treatment should be rapidly cooled to the 350 degree centigrade. So here it is the initial temperature 760 degree centigrade, and this is the rapid cooling up to the 350 degree centigrade, and this is now the stable hold for the 10^4 seconds. This is hold for the 10^4 second and quench to at the room temperature. So here we obtain the 100% of barite. In second example, the all the composition is same, and the initial temperature is 760 degree centigrade, and this is also rapid cooling up to the 250 degree centigrade, and it is again hold for the 100 seconds and conch to the room temperature. Conch means the cooling the metal at the rapid rate. So this is the we obtain the 100% austenite for this composition, and here it is the 100% mattersite below the eutectoid. When the temperature is below the 100 degree centigrade and the up to the 250 degree centigrade, the austenite 100% is obtained. Now in the third example, the same carbon alloy with the eutectoid composition, and this is the treatment, third treatment, and it is shown by the this line, and the rapid cool to the 650 degree centigrade. So this is the rapid cool, the 650 degree centigrade, and hold for the 20 seconds. This is hold for the 20 seconds. And rapid cool to the 400 degree centigrade. This is again the rapid cool up to the 400 degree centigrade and hold for the 10^3 seconds and quench to the room temperature, and we obtain the almost the 50% perlite and 50% austenite when it is cooled up to the 650 degree centigrade. And when the cooled up to the 400 degree centigrade, then the 50% barite is obtained, and the finally the temperature is just 100 degree centigrade, the 50% barite and 50% perlite we obtain. This is continuous cooling transformation diagram. Isothermal heat treatment are not the most practical due to rapid cooling and the constant maintain at the elevated temperature. The most heat treatment for the steel involve the continuous cooling of a specimen of the room temperature. The TTT diagram is modified to the CTT diagram. This is solid curve diagram. For the continuing cooling, the temperature required for the reactions to begin and end to the delay. The isothermal curve are the shifted to the long time and the lower temperature. Here it is, the initial curve is in dotted line and it is shifted up in the dark red in color. And this is continuing cooling, the time required for the reaction and begin and to the delay. So this is the cooling of the transformation, and this is also the perlite. This is continuing cooling transformation, and this is shift up to the initial point. This is moderate, rapid and the slow curve are the superimposed on the continuing cooling transformation diagram of the eutectoid iron carbon alloy. The transformation starts after the time period and corresponding to the intersection of the cooling curve with the beginning reaction and curve and the end up to the crossing the completion transformation curve. The normally bainite does not form when the alloy is continuously cooled to the room temperature, and austenite transform the perlite before the bainite has become the possible. Here it is the curve, this is cross the curve and it is cooled, and here it is the fine perlite is obtained, and this is the cool perlite is obtained, and it is moderate rapid cooling curve, and this is the slow cooling curve with the full annealing, and this is the normalizing process. So at the normalizing process we obtain the fine perlite, and when the annealing process the core perlite is obtained. For the continuing cooling of the steel alloy, there is exist a critical quenching rate at the represent the minimum rate of the quenching that will be produced a totally martensite structure. The curve will be just miss knows the perlite transform beginning. Here it is again, it is cooling at the rate of 140 degree centigrade per second, and here it is the 35 degree centigrade per second, and this is the critical cooling rate. These are the critical cooling rate, and in this region we obtain the martensite up to the minus 0.1 to the 10 seconds, and 10 seconds to the 10^3 martensite and the perlite, and after that the perlite we obtain. This is also again just touch the cooling curves, critical cooling rates. Continuing cool diagram for a 4340 steel alloy and the thermal cooling curve superimposed. This demonstrate the dependence of the final microstructure and the transformation that occur during the cooling. Alloying element used to modify the crystal cooling rate. The martensites are the chromium, nickel, magnesium, silicon and tungsten. So here it is, these are the cooling rates. This is on the 8.3 seconds per second, and this is on 0.3 centigrade per second, and this is on 0.02 centigrade per second, and this is on 0.006 centigrade per second. So these are the, at this region we obtain the austenite is converted into the martensites, and here it is the combination. This is the martensite, and here it is the martensite in the bainite, and here it is the martensite in the ferrite, and this region is the ferrite and the perlite. And now, due to the phase transformation, the mechanical properties are the change. The how to obtain the hardness. The Brinell and Rockwell are the two methods by which we hardness, we test the yield strength, tensile strength, ductility, percentage elongation, effect on the carbon content. These are the mechanical properties. Mechanical property influence of the carbon contains the perlite, medium ferrite, which is soft, and the composition we take again the 0.76 weight percentage of carbon, and this is called the hypoeudectoid. And in the second diagram, the perlite medium, the cementite, which is hard in nature, and the composition is again the 0.76 weight percentage of carbon, and the hyper-eudectoid reactions is occur. So here it is, this is the brittle hardness, and this is the yield strength value in the terms of times for 3 piles, and the here is the carbon weight composition of the carbon composition. So here it is the yield strength, and here it is the hardness, and this is the again the yield strength curve. So here it is the Brinell numbers, and in this this is the, we check the ductility in the terms of percentage and by the isor impact energy. So here it is, this is the elongation curve, and here it is the reduction in area, and this is the isor impact energy we show. So this is the combination of ductility in terms of the isor impact energy. Mechanical property iron carbon system, this is again the Brinell hardness numbers, and here it is the Rockwell hardness, and this is the fine perlite, this is for the coarse perlite, this is for the spheroidite, and the carbon percentage, and this is the ductility percentage, and for the spheroid, coarse perlite, and the fine perlite. And this is the tempered martensites. The tempered martensite is less brittle than the martensite tempered at the temperature of 594 degrees centigrade. Tempering reduction internal stresses caused by the crunching. The small particles are the cementite, the matrix at the alpha ferrite and US steel corporation. And here the curve, this is the tensile and the yield strength, and this is the tensile strength curve, this is the yield strength curve, and this is the reduction in area. Okay, and this is the temperature, tempering temperature. So here we increase the tensile strength and yield strength by the tempering process, and this is the microstructure of the tempered martensites. This is the hardness as the function of carbon concentration of the steel. So this is the Brinell hardness number, and this is for the martensite, tempered martensite at the temperature of 371 degree centigrade, and this is the perlite at the temperature of 200 degree centigrade, and this is the value of the Rockwell hardness number. And this is the Rockwell and the Brinell hardness number, the Rockwell hardness, and on that side the Brinell hardness, and this is on the temperature of 205 degree centigrade, and this is on the 350 degree centigrade, this is on the 425 degree centigrade, this is on the 535 degree centigrade. Hardness versus tempering time for the water quenching eudectoid plant carbon steel that is has been repeatedly quenching to the form martensite. Precipitation hardening, the strength and the hardness of the submetal alloy may be improved by formation of the extremely small uniformly dispersed particle precipitate for the second phase within the original phase matrix. the alloy that can be precipitated hard for the age hardened. Copper, beryllium, copper, tin, magnesium, aluminium, aluminium, copper, high strength aluminium alloy. Thank you very much.